I've been thinking about it for a while, and finally I decided to get my genome sequenced. When the results from dental labs arrived, I went through a roller coaster of feelings. I was excited to know every secret of my DNA, but I was afraid of getting to know my cancer risks and worried what else I might find. But for me, scientific curiosity always overrides fear, so I jumped into the unknown. And now I'm eager to share my results and experiences with you and with them.
This is Bertalan Meskó, and you're watching the channel of the Medical Futures.
First, a little history. When the Human Genome Project was completed in 2003, researchers said that learning about the functions of genes and proteins will have a major impact in the fields of medicine, biotechnology, and life sciences. But more than 10 years later, the revolution lags behind. Why is that? Well, the price of genome sequencing started around $3 billion, that's with a B. And even though by now it dropped below $1,000, it's still very expensive for the average consumer. But once the price reaches that of a blood test, it will become mainstream and change how we look at it and treat our health forever. The information gained from genetic sequencing can affect medication decisions, lifestyle changes and dietary choices, disease prevention plans, and life expectancy in general. It's exciting, helpful, and frightening at the same time. And don't mistake whole genome sequencing with simpler genetic tests that everyone seems to be taking these days. Companies like 23andMe can tell you more about your ancestry and some disease risks. So whole genome sequencing is like reading a book, while simpler tests only show a few pages. Let's see how genome sequencing works. You put some saliva into a standardized tube and send it back to the lab. Then comes the wait. 2 months. It was nerve-wracking. And as the DNA package contains a cancer risk report, I was terrified for what they might find. However, I do believe that you have to think proactively and that it's better to know the risks and to ensure preventive measures than bury your head in the sand. After 8 weeks, finally, my report was available. It contained more than 160 pages and my raw data. Dental Lab sequenced all my base pairs. Yes, it had the same amount too, and gave me a thorough overview of myself. Since reading genome sequencing could be a tough job to even an experienced physician, the report supports interpretation with several crutches. They visualize the likelihood of the risks with scales, and they emphasize how many studies the results are based on. I also contacted a genetic counselor and my primary care physician. So what have I learned? I have a moderate risk for melanoma, skin cancer. They suggest that tanning beds or sunburns should be highly avoidable for me. They also found a predisposition to thrombosis, blood clots forming in my veins. It turns out there's a reason why I hate long distance running. My genes predispose me for power training, the one I enjoy the most. Also, I had no idea before that I have a high risk for knee arthritis and moderate risk for hip and wrist arthritis. So I should rather not gain weight, and I should not wear high heels quite often. That the latter one came as a real shocker. So yes, I also learned some less relevant but amusing facts. Another one is that if I eat asparagus, I can smell it in my urine. That one changed my life forever. The report had a special section devoted to pharmacogenomics, which deals with drug responses. I received information about how my body metabolizes more than 100 drugs, which is incredibly useful. For example, my cholesterol level is usually higher than the reference value. However, I would definitely have severe side effects if I took prescription pills for lowering cholesterol. I learned similar risks in case I have to take some types of antibiotics and antidepressants. I also got calmed down when I realized I don't have any mutations in any of the known genes that would increase my risk for major cancer types. But a new study conducted that those who you live with have a bigger impact on your life expectancy than the genes you inherit from your parents. So while the information encoded in our DNA is unalterable, many medical conditions highly depend on the environmental factors. So for the next step, I packed up my data, I consulted my GP and my genetic counselor about the risks and prevention plans I can follow. Fortunately, I'm not alone in this fight, and you're also aided by technology and great medical professionals. That's why I advise you to have your whole genome sequenced. I already ordered 2 for the kids, 1 for my wife and 1 for my daughter. While analyzing that vast amount of data is still extremely challenging, even with trained professionals, if I only learned, you know, these snippets about my DNA and the future of my health, that's still very useful and impacted my lifestyle. This way, you can prepare for your own future in time to get from chance to choice. I'm glad that all these pieces of information are available to me now, and it might be very valuable in the future as data analytics will only get better.